Yes, good afternoon, everyone. And it's great to see you all and talk to you through the virtual space. Could I have, yes, my slide, please? I have thought that we have so many presentations today from the side of different organizations looking at what is happening. And I would like to ask already the second slide. So it is also important to look at what is happening out there and what we could expect from parties to do from their side to protect more environmental defenders. And we'll talk about that later. First, I just want to draw the conclusion from today's discussion, but also from other information, that we have seen an increasing threat to defenders, also in Europe, not only in other regions. And this includes many different type of, let's say, forms of persecution or harassment, or as we heard, as intimidation, etc., etc. But now, unfortunately, with Belarus, we are seeing even more aggressive forms of persecution, harassment, intimidation, etc., etc. We do not have so many reports about the situation. We can judge from what we hear from you and from cases. So it is also, it would be important also in the coming year to look to get more precise information on what is happening in Europe. Because as Jonas mentioned, there are some organizations which provide such a report analysis of other regions. So I, of course, want to welcome the activities of the Aarhus Compliance Committee in pursuing on cases which relate to non-compliance regarding Article 3.8 of the Aarhus Convention. And I find extremely important that we will have hopefully the adoption of the rapid response mechanism under the convention during next week in the MOP. Also, it was mentioned since we have gathered in actually 4 years ago in Budva, already there is the ESCATU agreement in force since May this year with its Article 9 on human rights defenders in environmental matters. Jonas has pointed out some of its features, so I am not going to go into details. I just say that it is also a very important precedent or let's say example in the history of multilateral environmental agreement next to the Aarhus Convention Article 3.8, which addresses the protection of human rights defenders in environmental matters. We know about existing mechanisms and recent developments of Human Rights Council, the special rapporteur on the situation of environmental defenders. Globally, there is the Inter-American Commission on Human Rights. UNEP has certain initiatives. And it is maybe also a good trend or sign that we have seen in at least in 2021, and also in 2020, some political declarations from the European Union, from the European Parliament. That is, was the resolution on the effects of climate change on human rights and the role of environmental defenders. This also includes a paragraph on the support to the ESCATU agreement, but also hopefully to environmental defenders in other regions. And there is the EU Action Plan on Human Rights and Democracy, which has also quite ample sections regarding the situation of environmental defenders. But as I said, all these mechanisms, especially Aarhus Convention Article 3.8, and can be implemented only if there are additional measures from parties. And same is regarding the rapid response mechanism. I would come back to that separately. So first of all, we expect that there are such pieces of legislation and there are such policies in the legislation of different Aarhus parties, which protect environmental defenders and aim at preventing such situations of harassment, intimidation, penalization, persecution, other forms of retaliations, including even more aggressive forms of attacks or killings, et cetera, which we can see now also in Europe, especially in Belarus. This obligation should include requirements for initiating investigations and prosecutions if such cases happen, but also providing assistance to victims in terms of legal assistance. We heard from Olena what is missing really, and especially in case of defenders, even more legal assistance may be needed. Psychological support, financial assistance, also could be other forms of assistance, including maybe taking out of them from the situation, from the country. It also may be an option, as we see some really threatening trends in Europe, for example, regarding Belarus. So the enforcement of Article 3.8, we expect, and the enforcement of the related national legislation. Now, coming to the rapid response mechanism, which we are very enthusiastic about and have high hopes for its functioning, we expect from parties support for this mechanism, even after adoption. So first adoption, then political support, and hopefully also financial support. And we would like to see the speedy implementation of this mechanism, as it really needs to play a role. If we mention, for example, a situation in Belarus or in some other countries that we have heard today, this rapid response mechanism will have quite a lot of cases probably where it should be activated or should intervene. Coming to some software aspects, because capacity building is needed in forms of trainings and maybe guidance and awareness raising for public authorities in the different Aarhus parties countries. But this should also include administrative organs, law enforcement agencies, the police, prosecutors, judiciary, as well as private security services and developers, international financial institutions. We also know about some cases in Europe as well where very sensitive development investment could be paired with the persecution or harassment of defenders. And there could be some projects which are funded or let's say considered to be funded by international financial institutions. But we may continue this line. Also, there is a need for awareness raising and capacity building among environmental defenders or environmental defenders to be, to know about the mechanism of rapid response, and also how it will work, how they can turn to this mechanism, how they can use or activate this mechanism. But there could be also valuable information provided regarding the national legislation, if exists, or its implementation, practicalities where they could turn if they need assistance in country or outside the country. And I could even continue again this. And it needs a format which is probably easily accessible and understandable. I put the last point, exchange of experiences and joint initiatives with the ESCASU agreement, as now they also have their Article 9, although they are still in the phase of organizing the first conference of parties next year. But after that, there already could be actions taken regarding Article 9, implementation of that article. And I think that Aarhus Convention and ESCASU agreement could jointly learn from each other's experiences and could also take some joint initiatives in the international field to promote further the protection of environmental defenders. So I'm just putting, asking for the last slide, which is mentioning the recent report, Last Line of Defense. I think Jonas mentioned this, which is an excellent report put out in September 2021 of the Global Witness, mainly focusing on cases of Latin America and Africa, which are maybe more, we know more about them. And then I'd like to mention that right now UNEP is starting a sub-regional research addressing environmental challenges through the law in Europe. And this is going to look at the situation of environmental defenders in Southeast Europe, Western Balkan countries. And should say, I was asked actually, and I'm doing my duty, that this is just ongoing project and Justice and Environment is contracted to prepare this research. Hopefully will be finished by end of November, and later this year, we will have access to this research. I mentioned this because I was saying that we don't know so much about the situation of environmental defenders. And I actually am very happy that also Belarus civil society and EcoHome in first place are also preparing a report or some kind of, let's say, informative report on the concrete situation on Belarus. And this could be shared also next week during the MOP. So I'm finishing at this point, and this could be debated further. So thank you for your attention, and let's devote some time to discussion. Thank you for your attention.